This is the Fourier series for a square wave. This may seem overwhelming, but this formula can be interpreted as a series of simple steps. The first step is to decide what amplitude and frequency we want for the square wave, say A and F. So we start with the first component, which is going to have an amplitude A times 4 over pi and frequency F. Then we add the second component, which is going to have an amplitude A times 4 over pi divided by 3 and frequency 3F. Since we are adding a small trough to a large crest, the result will have a small cavity in its crest. The third component is going to have an amplitude A times 4 over pi divided by 5 and frequency 5F. The subsequent components follow this pattern by going through the odd numbers, that is, 7, 9, 11, 13, etc. The pattern is infinite, so we have to stop at some point. This can be when we start to generate components that are outside of our audible range, or that are higher than the Nyquist frequency, or that exceed the capabilities of the loudspeaker. This would be the sequence of waves that results from adding components for a 400 Hz square wave. Each component is a sine wave, so the wave with only one component is a sine wave itself. Here, we can see how it gradually begins to take the shape of a square wave. Now, let's listen to how the timbre also starts out as a sine wave and gradually approaches a square wave.